Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair Live. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful video guys to any of you having a Kia Sportage or Kia Sorento guys, and you need to remove or replace serpentine belt tensioner pulley guys or idle pulley. Stay with us, we will explain how to do that in today's video guys. Everything from start to finish that should work on most generation Kia Sportage and Kia Sorento as well. So let's cover that today. So as we said, that should work on most generation Kia Sportage, Kia Sorento guys. Before we start, let me tell you, every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos guys. We take them completely apart and we show you how to fix pretty much anything. Why we do that? Simply because our mission in the shop is to save you as much money as we can. All we need in return, please guys, subscribe to the channel and like the video. Now, if you guys need to buy any parts or tools for a really good price and quick shipping as well, check out the link in the description of the video below and you can see where we get all our tools and parts from. So with that being said, let's explain, okay, how we're going to do that now. So you don't need to remove your engine guys, we simply have it out because we'll be making hundreds of videos guys, and we can show with the great detail where everything is located and check out the belt, how you can clearly see everything. Now before we start, many of you have been asking us guys what computers we use for diagnostics, because that channel we post quite a few diagnostic videos. So that's the one guys, it works on almost any car you can think of. It's amazing too, you can see it works on Kia and any car almost you can think of guys, and it's a tool that can pay itself off in one time use. I'll put a link where you can find more information on the current price in the description of the video below. Now this is guys the serpentine belt here. Depending on the generation Kia Sportage and Sorento, for instance, this 2.4 GDI engine has been used from year 2012 to year 2016, 17 even some models. This is right here, water pump, tensioner pulley, crankshaft pulley, AC compressor, idle pulley, alternator, another idle pulley guys. Now in order to remove the belt guys on the tensioner pulley, you have to place a wrench that fits. And now that wrench guys, okay, right here you're going to go ahead, okay, go counterclockwise and release the belt. Careful because it has quite a bit of tension. Now our pulley is broken guys, it's supposed to not go all the way like that, but ours is broken and we'll explain why. We'll go ahead, okay, and remove the belt. Now if you guys need to remove idle pulley, which is here or here, okay, it's pretty simple guys. You can just go ahead, okay, and get the bolt loose. Okay, once you get the bolt loose, you can simply go ahead, remove the bolt, and the idle pulley, okay, will come out. Perfect, like that. So, with that being said guys, okay, you can see it's come out, okay, and that's the bearing inside, that's what goes bad. And the other idle pulley is plastic, so they can usually fall apart too on higher mileage vehicles, guys. So, that's right there is the pulley, it did leak a little bit. This one is not so bad, but this one, ours developed some play. Now, I recommend when you replace one pulley, go with the whole kit guys. Replace the tensioner, the two idle pulleys and the belt as well. Now, the tensioner pulley guys, okay, it's actually reverse threaded, okay. It's reverse threaded because you go counterclockwise to get the belt loose. So, we're going to get that, okay. Bolt loose now. And the pulley will come out. The moment you remove the pulley, okay, right here is the bolt where it holds the tensioner, okay, to the bracket on the back that holds the alternator and the AC compressor as well. So we're going to go ahead, okay, and remove it. Now it's very important when you remove the tensioner guys, okay, the tensioner, okay, we have the new one right here. You have one tooth guys, okay, right here, one tooth, one dot, and it goes in that hole right there. Otherwise your belt will be sideways and can come off. So we'll go ahead, okay, remove the bolt from the pulley here. It's reverse threaded again guys, remember that. That's the only one that's reverse threaded on the tensioner. And once we remove the pulley, we can simply, okay, let me see now where exactly that thing is. Okay, it's a little bit limited room. Okay, let's start the bolt by hand a little bit. Okay, that's a 14 millimeter, 16 millimeter, my bad. Okay, perfect, it started, so we can go ahead, okay, get it tight now. Okay, get it tight. Now next step, you grab your pulley, install the pulley. You can see how it's supposed to stop right here, but that tensioner is broken, guys, on the backside right here. It's broken, cracked, and yeah, that shot. And now we are going to install the pulley itself. Make sure everything spins nice and easy. You can see how tight this one is. This one is about to go. It's creating quite a bit of noise. Hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful. All you have to do is install your belt, and after that, you're ready to go. So thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to the channel and see you guys next time.